Paji, only two debuts. Nothing. Welcome. What a wonderful evening to have this match here between UZ Markhor versus Patiala Shahi Cricket Association. Indeed, a wonderful evening here to start our summer between the Patiala Shahi and UZ Markhor. The toss update where Dilroop Ghumman playing his match as his captain. The responsibility has been put on the young shoulders and regulation delivery. This is a star-studded match between the UZ Markhor and Patiala Shahi Cricket Club. We've got four newbies debuting for Patiala Shahi Cricket Club. We've got two stars, very own, renowned, profound and prolific all-rounders. That is Saad Bin Zafar, the captain of Cricket Canada, and Rizwan Cheema, the very own our Canadian star who was vice-captain in 2011 World Cup held in India. Going so far, so good. Just warming up, trying to maintain consistency. Dilrup leading the attack, being the captain, won't be easy for him because he's got he's lashed it to the sweeper and just a single. The toss wouldn't affect the decision, but being a captain, he would have wanted his plans to work out initially. They might have wanted to bat on first because they've got the team combination that is three bowlers. So they've put more emphasis on the batting side, having four all-rounders in the side and four batsmen as well. Arman Kapoor taking his guard. He's ready with shivering his gloves and little stretches. Shimmy on. Butterflies, what is it going to be? We've got Dilrup again on the attack. Who's going to be the spell? Regulation again in the block hole on point delivery. Rumi has been one of the dominant batsmen. Amazing. I cannot forget the strike what he had hit over inside out through the covers for a six. Not an easy shot. Being a wicketkeeper, having a steady, calm head like Romi Dhaliwal as their wicketkeeper would definitely add an advantage to them. Dance off the track and what a jaffer. That is a ripping delivery. How has Dilrup managed to pull that? Not an easy line, not an easy length. If he's bowling again with that consistency and consecutiveness on that line, won't be easy for any batsman where the ball is swinging in air. And if the ball is taking the seam of the surface, again, not an easy track to bat on against this attack leading by Dilrup. Who's going to be his fellow partner in action? From the other end, it'll be easy for Dilrup to have his fellow comrade who is as good as him, who's got unique pace. Simran Gagan being the two newbies along with Rizwan Chima and Saad bin Zafar. Simran leading the attack. He played for Knights and recently joined Patiala Shahi with the determination and ambition to grow his cricket. Definitely one of those cricketing club where cricket is booming and taking the march of pride. Simran was amazing in the TND league match. It was very difficult through the lines what he is bowled to play him. The right-handed batsman dances down the track again. Little stretches for the umpire, deviating from his line and length. Early stretches for the umpire. One thing what they would want to contain them is that again from one tournament jumping on to other tournament. And if you look at this dimension of this ground and the surface, how this ground is built, they've got the boundary what is located, that is the midan boundary again. Could not get the ball. The ball is zipping. The ball was jacked onto his pads. Could not get the right amount of bat to whack him around the park. They've got a slip in position. Aggressive thinking from Dilrup. If you look at the wicketkeeper, he's standing way far behind. Look at the pace, look at the carry, look at the bounce. Lashes, would it be a catch? What an amazing catch! What an amazing catch! The first blood has been drawn in form of Arman. He is pulled off a blinder. Can you believe that? He was in two minds to whether to come, whether not to come. When a situation is like this, you usually end up leaving a boundary as well. Forget about the wicket, but a magnificent catch being taken. He's held his eyes on the ball till the end of the moment. And Bhagwan Singh does not leave a catch. First blood, first wicket down in the form of Arman. And new man coming in. Regular wickets in interval is what we've seen from this club. Look at the team spirit. They are gathering for a good team huddle. Gathering again for a strategy to be implemented. Again, if they get the strategy right, what they've put on the paper, what they've formulated, this is going to be an interesting game because UZ Markhor have got that firepower in their batting, and if they try to pull it off, it's going to be one of the competitive matches of this league stage. Amazing. Beautifully said by Simmer because he was giving him the room, has given him the width. He wanted the batsman to slash. He's played the under edge of the bat. Could have chopped on. But the type of bounce, the type of carry is on this wicket. It is equivalently good to the batting side as well as the bowling side. Because on this AstroTurf, you really cannot predict the way the bounce carries. It comes onto your bat. Again, it is a matter of the thinking, the strategy, the tactfulness in your mind, the way you carry. Any predictive shots leaves out. To the bottom of the bat, to the gully fielder. Would have to see the type of captaincy Dilrup would have. He's an enthusiastic cricketer himself. His eyes light up every time he's playing cricket. Bangs and shots, slashes. Fielder in place. We'll just get one. Two overs, a very good start. Two overs completed and just four runs conceded. And one wicket lost for UZ Markhor. Hassan shall be accompanying Ramiz. They lost their fellow comrade early on. Dilrup again, trying to spill his magic. Straight to the fielder. And the ball pops out. We'll have to see a team huddle. Dilrup was full of energy, motivating his fellow teammates. Hassan Adil. On the non-striker and wanted to pull on the back foot, but could not get the timing on. A good mix and match of the line, length, varying his pace. You can see he's got that Cuban chain on. He's a man with the style. He is pretty relaxed, but when it comes to game, he is a hothead. Takes on, cries of catches. Someone getting. Chima himself. But could not reach the ball. Not easy to have a catch like that when the ball's turning, swirling in air and you are running behind for the catch. Was there an opportunity or are we being ambitious about that opportunity? He's one of the gun fielders you can find. Not easy for the ball to pierce him and fall anywhere. Takes on again. Is there going to be an opportunity? Will be a chase. Ball trickling. We've got a fine outfield here and will end up resulting in a boundary here. Very good shot. He's brave enough to take on a fielder like Chima. He has got a well-built height, a good personality, and a fielder standing like him, it creates an aura, an energy that you be in a dilemma whether to take on a shot like that or not. Again, credits to the bowler having a wicket fall, trying to boost the morale. We've got quite a good amount of spectators here enjoying our cricket on this fine evening. Is it for a boundary? Oh, very well. He's dug out. He's dug that out swiftly and craftily. The rupiah. I mean, this has been a fashion with the bowlers that whenever they overtry or overdo something, if they are in the hunt of wickets, then they end up leaking runs. But instead, if they are trying to stick up to the consistency and the line and the length, if they are just going ball by ball, if we see cricket, because it changes, the momentum changes, the shift, the gears, it changes completely. If you see that one team is being dominant right now, cricket changes swiftly and the gears turn up so quickly in a time that you feel that the game is equal and again the other team's being dominating. So if you look at that, if the bowler is over trying something, he induces and loses his track of line and length and becomes very easy for the batsman to come down. Again, end of the over to operate from the other end. His fellow comrade Simmer back in attack. Bangs and shot. Again, fielder in position. Will just see the ball. Very well fielded. He's plucked out of nothing. He's plucked that ball. He did not lose hope. Every run here counts. If you're looking to build onto a target and restrict them to a total, then you got to run hard and you got to ensure that every ball has been protected from running away to the fence. Straight down the track. No way better. Some football skills here on the field. It's one sport, but this has been aggregated and combined of other sports. What you see here, a few football tricks and the batsman trying to slug it as hard as a baseball batsman. Whole different structure, the way cricket has been evolved from the time it's played to the T20s coming in and the T10. Interesting fact that T10, when it was played last year, very good, very well-directed bouncer. How fierce is that hostile piece of bowling? Beautiful, directed towards the blind spot. Nothing but the batsman had to get away out of that fierce delivery. The interesting fact that the way the structure that has been evolved in cricket is that T10, when it was played, Jannatpreet Singh had managed to pull off a blinder innings. Dances down the track. We'll get back to that. What a lovely piece of work. What a lovely piece of fine work. You couldn't ask anything better from one of the finest cricketing players of the fast bowling. He's just used his quick wrist, he's powered it down, did nothing but just timed it to perfection. These types of shots would be expected from Adil. He's walked in for an early fall of wicket. So to construct, to build upon that type of innings will be really important here. This wicket, one more wicket and pressure would be on here. And some more runs, some more boundaries if they can put in sensible cricket. Sensible cricket. He isn't trying to do something fancy here. He's got a boundary and again, bit by bit, piece by piece, ball by ball, he's trying to take the game deep. What a fine shot it was that he has played onto the mid-wicket. Nothing. Just a piece of his wristy work. Not everyone's gifted with that fine wrist work, if you see. To have that piece of timing. Takes on. opens full face of the bat. He's getting the width and he's trying to capitalize onto the width. The field is rightfully set up, four overs completed, and the score is 21 on the loss of one wicket. UZ Markhor trying to make their mark, trying to head towards a respectable total. I wonder what the batting strategy would have been, the type of running runs they would have wanted to put on. The projected score might have been here. This is a big ground. If you look at the boundary dimensions, the covers, the mid-wicket, they are bigger than the other sides. But this is a well constructed, well-designed ground where, if you see, the diameters of this ground is well circular in shape, not like the ground which is oval and when we played the other tournament, T&D. Dilroop to continue. He's been in a fine form. Oh, lovely. His ball that he's managed to dug out. Powerfully struck down the track for one. Rizwan Chima on the long off boundary. He's tall. It would not be easy to clear him. That's why when you are playing cricket, you take into consideration of all the facts, how quick and how agile the fielder is. And trust me, Chima is just getting younger and younger. The days pass on. Quick single. Very good running between the wickets. Communication has been the key, because we see that when the quick call's been made and the fielder is stationed, it is not easy for the batsman to take a single, because there's a definitely mix and match of the calls. But this exhibits a good running and good communication between the team players. And this good communication also represents how good of bonding do you have in your team. Or wants to slog. Sloppy there. The way we were talking about the interesting evolution of cricket, now the T10s that's been brought into picture, that Jannatpreet Singh, who's been a magnificent striker, slugger, he's shackling the ball and he's managed to pull off in a T10 tournament 100 out of just 29 deliveries. Can you believe that? That's a boisterous shot again onto the pads, bread and butter shot for Ramiz. I'm sorry, is it Adil? Or Rami is quite difficult to pick. Indeed, that is Adil. Who can forget that mid-wicket shot, what he had clipped from his pad. Again, a bread and butter shot, loose delivery, trying to intimidate him. But pace has been his key strength to time the ball to perfection. This is well bowled, well directed, again on his toes. Would be very interesting what Dilroop would try to do here. Anything extraordinary or stick to his basics? Over by over passing. It's going to be pretty chilly here. Takes on, good lash, oh, he would have pulled a screamer. Time jump, but could not get his hands exactly. And who was it? One of the energetic, electrifying fielders on the field, Saad bin Zafar. 5 overs completed, going at a steady run rate, 6 per over. 30 runs of 5 overs and 1 wicket down. Nothing sumptuous from either of the team. A good side for Patiala Shahi cricket is that they've managed to pull one wicket in an early stage. And good news for UZ Markhor is that after that quick loss of one wicket, Adil has tried to steady their ship. Uh, If Adil bats on for consistent overs here, it's going to be an alarming sign for Patiala Shahi, because the way, the fashion he's been playing, using his wrist, he's coming down the track, he's seeing the ball well from his grill, it's not going to be easy, and looks like we've got a storm incoming. That'll be Adil again if Patiala Shahi wants to restrict them to a total. If they want to strangle something around the neck and suffocate them, would be to bring on Ramiz back on strike. And yes, keeping the scoreboard ticking. Yeah, the strategy to play basic cricket. It's just that nothing extraordinary, nothing fancy here, whimsical. Because you know the conditions, you assess it properly, then it becomes very easy for you to understand the type of strategy the fielding team's implementing on the ground. And if you're trying for something whimsical, if you're trying to premeditate it, it's nothing, not your cricket, but your passion over your stubbornness taking you over. Thuds onto his pads, nothing trying to take on, risky. The side being well balanced here, three bowlers. Again, the question would be, would they be required to bring in an extra bowler, or they are trying to balance it with the fourth all-rounder what they are having in here? We haven't seen a spin coming on here yet, because the power play, this is the last over of power play. Again, he's dug that well. Well-directed Yorker, just like a bowling machine. He's accurate, fine with his length. The coaches on the boundary line for Patiala Shahi cricket will be very happy with the bowling attack. They're having lashes on again. He slapped that. Cries of catches. Will the cry be answered? The ball lands in the no man's land. False shot. If you look at the bowling area, if the bowlers that have been trying to bowl, that has been the area little shorter of the good length than the halfway tracker or the short length, and two or three delivery. This is well directed. This is well directed. Oh, how have you managed to put that down? A sitter. That is a sitter. Would not have been expected for a fielder, captain himself. Would this be the danger wicket? Would Adil make him regret, or was that Ramiz? Would they make the fielder and the bowling team pay the price for this? The question shall unravel. And would this be the misery, the catch? Would that put them in the shoes and tie them to something what they are not expecting? What are we here to witness? Six overs completed. So far, the run rate's been put down. They've made them use UZ Markhor to stagger a bit. And the run is 32 on the board and one wicket down. Hasan Adil, 14 runs, and the technical issues being resolved. I mean, if you're one of those guys here, or one of those people who supports hardcore cricket, I think definitely you can follow Patiala Shahi on the social media, because they've been trying to promote cricket in a country where people are unaware of this game, but still having bringing in the communities. If you look at the combination what Patiala Shahi cricket is used it here, saying that the fringes are not something to stop the players to play cricket. They've amalgamated good talent from various regions. The last year, they've got a few Caribbean spice in their team. We've got a few flavor from Pakistan across the boundary, some from India. So I think this has been one of the finest cricketing clubs here in Canada. The type of cricket what they've been promoting, definitely the competitive cricket. Bangs and shot. Just like a catapult action, the way he is loading, he's going back. He's trying to accumulate and accommodate all of his pace in one delivery and bang in. Interesting fact here would be that Adil has played less number of balls, and Ramiz playing on 17 of 20 deliveries. Oh, nicely bowled between the stumps. Nothing, just to tuck it for one. Nothing. Very well directed. Very well directed. If they're trying to maintain the similar type of energy, and if they're trying to restrict them even for ones and twos, the batsman is going to come down and try to do something which is not expected. And that would end up either for him to play the shot out of frustration, or he is definitely going to break the shackles. Again, would be a very brave piece of bowling if he's trying to bowl something between the three stumps very well. This is what we see, that if there aren't runs coming, the batsman usually sticks, rather than sticking to his wicket, he comes down the track. And the key here to keep the pressure away would be that communication, the way the batsmen, both of them communicate, and they try to hold the wicket and try to score runs. So that, lovely, he's lofted that, lofted drive, and bringing, reminds me of one of the test cricket incidents where either it was Jones or McGrath who was trying to throw the cricket ball, and he ended up blasting her off his own specs. Oh, nicely played, nicely played. Was hit hard. Very difficult, and a very harsh ask from the fielder to leap onto catches like that. Would have been one of those situations where he would have ended hurting himself, because the ball was hit with full might and it fell short. And again, for a catch to be taken like that, he would have had to put himself bending low. Not easy. What he tried to do is that to save a run instead of going for the attempt. Sane call indeed. Gagandeep Singh, one of the intriguing facts, what we'll talk about him when he comes back again on the attack, would be very interesting to know about him. We've got few facts again, this left-arm pacer. Oh, what has he done? What has he done? What has he done? That is the biggest. That is the biggest. He's showcasing his skills here of how well he's capable of that big hitting ability. What a magnificent strike. He was just toying around with the bowler. Something to relish on. Something to cheer on for UZ Markhor. The fielder was just the spectator. Rami is trying to break the shackles and free, take off the pressure of his fellow mate Adil. Again, good running. Good running between the wickets. Kamalveer Singh. How well has been the role of wicketkeeper? Because having a wicketkeeper like Romy himself, who is well aware of the game situation, who can guide the bowler according to the situation, is a big blessing in disguise. Look at him. How quick is he on his feet? He knows that the fielder is slightly away, and anything inert would end up in two runs instead of one. So it is very good to have a keeper. There you go. You can have Romy running across the stumps on his field, and very good attempt indeed. All to you, brought to you by 6X. What a lovely play. What a lovely play. He has come down the track. He is trying to take off the helicopter here. Are we trying to take a helicopter off the helipad? We've got something fancy coming up. how well he's managed to take off that Yorker and converted that. He's trying to slug it. He's been like a slughead, slugging every ball like a lumberjack, everything coming in his way. Either it's been hit with immense force, immense power, and definitely Adil with his fine wristy, having a feisty player like that, they're going to definitely talk the innings. Ah, lovely, lovely piece of cricket. He has definitely modulated his pace, he's changed his pace, but the batsman read him well enough. They've got a fine third man, Yuvraj, one of the versatile batsmen. Oh, would be very, very lovely to see him bat if he's wearing those colours on. We haven't seen spin yet. Interesting strategy. 8 overs been passed and still out of those big heads, that wonderful drive onto the covers and extra cover region. We haven't found anything big coming up. So are they going to target any individual bowler that they are going to run after and trying to score the runs and having a bag on? There's some energy shouts from Dilroop, from captain himself, keeping the energy on. Oh, lovely. How good is that? How good is that? Nothing but exposing your stumps. And this can be extremely dangerous because the pace, the line and the length Gagan is bowling is you miss, I hit. Definitely one of those quickies you do not want to toy around with. He's not for fun. Finest left-arm pacers in Ontario. Again, a boundary comes up. They are rejuvenating and renouncing the innings for UZ Markhor. Picking on his sides well. And if you're going after this fine, fast left-arm pacer, then you are breaking the spine bone of Patiala Shahi cricket. But it wouldn't be easy because he's got that exposure, he's got that experience, and he's well aware of his bowling, what are his strengths and where he can direct the ball, what areas. Would be very interesting to have a battle between Gagandeep Singh and Adil, because the way Adil has been batting, I'm just trying to see that if he's anything that what he can do that tries to take out and use his fine wrist work and work something magical. There you go. Drills it down the ground for one. Ready. Look at the batting position. He goes deep inside the crease. The way he is swinging his bat to collect enough time. This track is rock solid, and what you can expect is a good bounce. And if you're directing, they've got Kamal Siddhu, my apologies, who's one of the fastest bowler in the side, and they can well utilize him. It's better to utilize him than to take his overs home. Yes and no. First hesitation is what we've seen here. And now the cricket, if we are talking about the evolution, the way we were talking about at T10 cricket and the way Jannat Preet has managed to score 100 runs, not easy. I really don't know. I guess he was definitely batting on a whole different surface, a whole different planet, because it's really not easy for someone to score consistently in a fashion where he's managed to pull out 100 runs in just 29 deliveries. And definitely when someone comes in fielder, a quick sub for you to give water or change the helmet. There's definitely going to be a word from the dugout, from the coach or from the captain that there's going to be a change, a little change in the strategy and how they're supposed to play, a direction coming in. And spin coming in. The answer from the question from the commentator has been answered here. We questioning that why hasn't there been an introduction of the spin? And who is it? Who is it from our very own Canadian Skippy? That's Saad bin Zafar. Intriguing fact that he has bowled four overs, and can you imagine how many maidens has he bowled in one inning? Catch, cries of catches. His overs are going to be very crucial here because this would elevate the team's morale, motivation, and definitely open a pathway for the spinners, and shall be leading on his footprints. Because, and talking about Saad bin Zafar, an amazing bowler, not just because of his bowling skills, but because of his accuracy as well. How can a person manage to bowl 24 balls in the same region, same direction, with the same level of consistency, same level of accuracy? And one of the records what he holds and the feather what he's added to his cap is that he's bowled four maidens in an innings in a T20 game. Can you imagine that? Four overs in an innings, four complete overs, giving nothing, and he's plugged two wickets as well. I mean, there are a lot to come. He's a young cricketer. Look at him running, chasing behind the ball. He hasn't waited for anything. This is what we've been telling. And he's got an accolade of the best fielder as well, the cap he adorns and wears. There's a lot of cricketing left for him, and the way he is marshalling the Canadian side, and under his leadership, we are definitely going to see a lot of cricketers, young cricketers, being shaped for Canada. He is a well-ornamented cricketer, Saad bin Zafar. He's been a decent striker of the ball, and to have a handy all-rounder, I think this defines the strategy and the promotion, the tactic, whatever you can say. The type of cricket Patiala Shahi cricket has been trying to promote here is that they are trying to bring in the faces the world knows, and we talk about Rizwan Cheema or the Canadian captain himself, that is Saad bin Zafar. They're trying to give that leverage, they're trying to give that exposure and impression and the atmosphere to the young cricketers, what they are trying to bud in. A lot of opportunities, this unique club, excuse me, and that was a full toss, could have hit anywhere in the ground, was a gift, but he's managed to put that down. He declines the offer from Saad, and the over has been completed, 10 overs completed, and the score is 60 on the loss of one wicket. 10 overs completed. Another star player. I reckon there aren't going to be any stars in the night sky because everyone's playing here in the Andrew McCandless ground here. We've got another star player, Harsh Thakur. One prominent fact about Harsh has been that he's been quick through the air and has managed to give the flight as well with that. So if you're being quick through the air and the batsman dances down the track and he's giving a little shimmies and he's got some moves, then there's going to be a chance of stumping. This is what we've been talking about. He slogs. This time, no chance for the keeper or the bowler. He's answering well here. Signs of tiredness from the striker. Ramiz, he's managed to put 41. And suddenly, Ramiz has been leading the attack up front. Says, Adil, why don't you take up the back seat? And this has been lashed out. Yes or no, cries of keeper. He's coming back. The throw, would the throw have been better? He would have been in trouble and running straight back to the dugout in the same direction. Adjacent. Look at his run up, the way he loads. Half tracker. Fielder positioned to the square. This spin twin would be an interesting combination here. The reason is because Harsh is bowling slightly slower through the air right now and trying to give flight. There you go. And Saad trying to bowl quick through the air. It would be very, very difficult and not easy for the batsman to read them, because one's bowling slow through the air, giving flight, inviting the batsman, saying the batsman, inducing him to take on, and one bowling through the air, trying to cramp him up. Takes on, and not the type of shot what he wanted to play, still gets one. Smack that, and straight. Can you imagine? Straight to the fielder's pouch, who's stationed at long off. He didn't have to do much. Just have to come two or three steps forward. There you go in the replay. Well, probably a different replay. And Bhagwan Singh again. Definitely. Bhagwan is not finding the ball. The ball's finding Bhagwan today. Bhagwan's been favorite of the ball. And a fielder to look out for. It's dangerous. No one's got nine lives today if Bhagwan stationed is being the station fielder. It's risky here to give catches to Bhagwan. And let me remind you, a couple of chances that were put down. Rami is still on strike, but Adil, whose catch was put down, I think wouldn't be much regret right now that would sting, because Adil hasn't scored much. But two wickets down, 11 overs completed, and this is what we've been talking about. Harsh Thakur, the very own himself, the partnership breaker, has provided the breakthrough. This match is very interesting because the way Patiala Shahi cricket has been trying to give the things, give the task here. We've got two very senior players who's well-known, well-profound of game, but they're still given the captaincy to Dilroop. And the type of aura, the type of impression what both of them, Saad and Chima, has, they've been very calm, complacent. And he's cleaned up. Zinger bails light up and he's opened the gates. Is this the flurry of wickets here? He was very close. He was very close, Ramiz. And there you see Zinger Bales light up. A gift to our hard-working, enthusiastic Jimmy Sharma, what he's received. And he is, again, giving it back to cricket. What an amazing addition this has been to cricket. Zinger Bales, where everyone dreams about having an international exposure. And what Jimmy Sharma, the founder who's established Patiala Shahi cricket in 2017, is trying to promote and give the best back to the cricket. Ramiz goes by, who was having a blistering knock, but being dusted. Falls to dust. Brings in new man who will join alongside with Nikhil Datta. Yes is the call. The ball chasing the fielder. What a valiant effort. What a valiant effort in the field by Jannatpreet Singh. Just not by the bat, also contributing by saving valuable runs to his team. Clips off the pad. Just for a single. And who do we have on the non-strikers end is known figure again from the Canadian cricket. It's Nikhil Datta. He is playing against Patiala Shahi cricket for the first time. And he shall have little taste of Patiala Shahi here. But he's a known belligerent player of the cricketing ball. Uneven bounce. He's got his helmet on. That'll save Romy from unnecessary, unwanted injuries. 70 runs. Still, this game is still one well balanced, not leading. How well? He's startled. Skipper showing some trick. He's got a bag of tricks and he said that you're against me, I'll give you something. You'll have a fine taste of me. Bowling. This one's slightly quicker through the air. Well directed between the stumps. End of the over. Two overs, nothing. Keeping it tight, consistent. As usual, fashioned Saad bin Zafar. 9 runs, 1 wicket for him named. And 70 runs off 12 overs. So far, the scoreboard looks like this, where 45 runs were put on slightly ahead of his balls. 40 balls what he's faced, and Amar has been off to a nut on a duck after facing 3 deliveries. Hassan Adil, who was looking good in his donned clothes, has been sent back to the pavilion of 21 runs facing 24 balls. Now we've got Nikhil Datta and Danish. We've got Kalpit to come in. Saad, Mansoor, Arman, Sultan and Uzair. As hit back to the bowler. Cuts it. The fielder trying to wonder, should I dive or not? But he lets the ball seep through him. 71. I wonder if they are trying to contain the UZ Markhors within the range of 145 to 150. I think Dilroop and his team would have done a wonderful job. Straight back. Nothing. Harsh keeping it tight. And he's being stingy. Good try, good attempt. Yes, no. It is too hard from the fast bowlers to expect because we've seen that Ishan Sharma as well. If there's any ball going through them, they do not want to dive and have unnecessary injuries. Also, it is because of the built personnel. Very well fielded. Very well fielded. A saved run. A saved run. Because it takes a lot of time for them to go down on the ball. And the time they go down, the ball again takes the fence. Pushes back himself, trying to come for the second. Easy, comfortable running. This can be something intriguing to watch if they are trying to convert ones into twos and putting some pressure on the fielders. I think that would help them to open a door for them, for the runs, rather than tussling too hard. end of the over, 13 overs completed and 1374 runs. This is what the scoreboard looks like. They've got few more batsmen to come in. Currently running at 5.59. Sad back, and keeper and the bowler is what they are trying to portray here. They're trying to exhibit that there's no more batsmen available on the crease. It's just the keeper and the bowler. Takes on. Are the cries of catches going to be answered, or is it going far off the fence? Oh, what a wonderful catch. What a wonderful catch he's taken. He's teasing the batsman that, is this where what you wanted to hit? But he is managed to pull, and that is the area where you do not have the exposure and the light there. And the light's been fading away. So indeed, a very good catch here. The ball was hit right in the air. The ball had elevation, had the height, not the distance. And one more wicket perishes. Right now, UZ Markhor is in a great peril. Is there going to be their savior? Is there anyone who's going to pull their ship off from this whirlpool? Is there going to be anyone who's going to play the role of that steady captain to steady their ship by the whirlpool created by Patiala Shahi? Again and again, this team has been consistently taking wickets in regular intervals. When we say regular intervals, this has been the fashion of this team, because they have not allowed to the batsmen to settle down on the track and witness something and read the ball well. We've seen some magnificent bowling where the bowler is trying to make the batsman smell the leather and passing it back to the pouch of wicketkeeper. And now the spin twin, what the trick has been done is by Harsh Thakur and Saad bin Zafar, is that they've been trying to give the breakthrough for the team. This is the type of environment what Patiala Shahi Cricket Club, one of the finest cricket clubs, they've been doing it again and again, again and again. The type of cricketing service, the type of coaching to the players they've been providing. Their proud sports partner that they've partnered up with, one of the leading, prominent, dominating figures and the names in Canada is Yashi Sports. They've tied up with. And what a facility they're having. Interesting fact is that Romy has been put the responsibility of captaining the side. He's pushed it, nudged it away to the third man. The third man's been stationed slightly finer, but he's managed to play it wider. I think this is what Patiala Shahi Cricket is trying to insinuate in this club, trying to give more responsibility to the youngsters, is because this is the type of formation the team is having. If you look at the statistics and the type of mindset what the team or the founder or this club runners have, the people who are behind the scenes, is that they're trying to bring in the new talent into the game. And if you look at the structure, the way this club has been structurized, is because they currently have core team members, be it Rizwan Chima, Saad bin Zafar, Rehan Pathan, and Yuvraj Samra himself, a youngster, prolific youngster, but he has been a core integral part of this team. So they're trying to bring in new talent, a new addition to this team, so that, oh, what a shot, what a shot. One down, is there going to be a catch? And Yuvraj Samra again. It is Yuvraj Samra, we've been talking about him, and you cannot keep him out of the game. The passion this young cricketer has for the game is outstanding. He's always got his mother on the field when he's playing BDCL. His father himself has played cricket, and what a versatile player he is. He's too young. He's got a lot of cricket coming up for him. has got a lot of matches to play. And this is what the strength is. Every wicket, every over, what they're talking is that communicating. This is how the free-flowing environment is. Despite the seniors, what they have on the field, Dil Roop captaining, it has been communicated very lucid to them that keep it very simple. Let's play it to the basic ground, to the basics of the cricket. And this is what they've been playing, managing to put the best form of cricket what they're playing. And this is what the score for the bowling looks like. Where Harsh Thakur's managed to get two wickets. Dil Roop, the captain, three overs, very economical, nothing extra. Six, Simarjeet Dillon, who's got one wicket, two overs, again economical. Kamalveer Singh, the fastest, speedy gun, bullet train, has got 15, slightly expensive from his comrades. He would be unhappy about the fact that he's conceded 15, but to be very honest, I think I'm being very harsh on him, that it's very normal in a T20 game. And what have we seen here? Some slip and falls. Two wickets. Romy, the wicketkeeper, look how close he's standing to the stumps. And subtle changes to be made in the field by Harsh. Ball running down. There's no third man on the boundary. There's no boundary raider there. So two runs. So Amar. Five wickets. They've been choking, always being choked. The opposition we've seen in TND League as well. A lot of cricket coming up for Patiala Shahi. And if you're looking to join this club, the best way is for them to be updated about what they're doing is them to follow. Let Jimmy Sharma hear your voice. That you want to follow this club, or if you want to do something regarding cricket, the best way to reach out to them is via social media, the best tool in a modern day generation. You can follow them on official Patiala Shahi Cricket on Instagram and Facebook. The best way you can get your responses, and if you want something to be done into the game, and trust me, they do take your suggestions on. And they're very serious and finicky about what they're doing for cricket. This one's faster, and he hasn't given much flight. He has been very crafty bowler. The reason why I say is that he's making subtle changes. Nothing much with the line, but with the length and the variation what he's bowling. And if you look at the trajectory, he isn't bowling the wide arm spin, but he's been bowling that looping spin, which goes around the arm. Again, overs completed, 15. The run rate is on 5.27. Only one extra. What an amazing figure this has been. 79 on the loss of four wickets. And if you look at the fall of wickets, early breakthrough on 3, 67 and 67. That is when they've lost the wicket. There was a long span, the interval what they had for the wicket. And 66, 76 after that, a regular quick succession when they lost their wicket again. Last over of Saad bin Zafar. Can he do something again? The ask is too much because a player of his caliber, we definitely, the expectations are going to be high from the type of player he is. And we've got decent amount of spectators here visiting this game. And this is what it is, that people love cricket. This is the time having spectators. And this shows how well. And the keeper is also startled by this delivery. The crowd here is amazing. Have been constant supporters of Patiala Shahi cricket. And because the type of platform this club has been giving is amazing. Keeper, yes, no, little sloppy, still he is happy. Umpires have been pretty immaculate, and you can see Jannat Preet on your screen smiling. Three more balls remaining, something coming up. Has he got something rolled up his sleeve? 16 and 2 wickets. 16 is what we've conceded. Again, he's pushed it straight. What they would want to do is that the line through what they've wanted to play is across the stumps. What the players would have wanted to do in the fall of wickets is that they would have wanted to play something between the V, that is the safest, over the head of the bowler. But the cause of wicket, Gadas is down the round. And Romy Dhaliwal, he's got fastest hands, trust me. But he's put that down. The ball has beaten even the keeper. Tricky, tricky piece of keeping again, but Saad is happy because he knows that the ball was delivered slightly faster than the regular pace. 16 overs completed, 87 on the loss of 5 wickets. What is this? Definitely a turmoil for UZ Markhor. Anything if they are restricting under 100, it is an impeccable total for the bowling team to restrict. And Dilroop as the captain in the very first game, a remarkable feat for him. Again, take a bow to the skippy. 4 overs completed, 19 on the loss of 2 wickets. He has given some crucial breakthroughs. 4 overs, last quarter. Are we going to see some gigantic hits here? Or is it going to be the consistent fall of wickets? Leads forward, nothing. Says no. Was there a run? He is limping. How have we've seen your shoe coming off. Comedy of errors. They've got again in 2016 when Gujarat Lions, they had Gujarat Lions playing against Sunrisers. When the shoe was off, that David Warner was the batsman and the bowler was Basil Thumpy. He gifted the shoe back, returned him back to Basil Thumpy. Reminded me of that memorable day where David Warner was playing. What a left-hander he is. What a vibrant left-hander. Takes it off, the fielder in position, Staten. Yes, no. Oh, you stationary man. He wouldn't have picked up a good call from the non-strikers. He's like, what are you doing? Where are you seeing? He's putting on the black robe. The jersey, black and gold. The royalty, the pride of Lions for Patiala Shahi Cricket. Brings him on to the front foot. What a piece of bowling this is. How well accurate can you be? Nothing's going bad here except for a couple of catches here or there. I think even Cat has 9 lives, and if you are... Oh, lovely. He's played that with a straight bat. And if you're being remarkable throughout your game, I reckon one or two sins are to be forgiven. That covers up. Those blemishes are still going to be covered up if you've got good rest of your day. How well can this wonderful club go without sponsors? Our proud sponsors are Builders Bliss Stone and Tiles of Paradise, Babamore Transport Logistics and Intermodal Services, Raleigh Poly, Cow Delicious to the last bite. Indeed delicious, just like the game what we are playing here. Enjoying, everyone's been enjoying. Soak Tax and Financial Services, this represents the stingy piece of bowling. If you want to be precise, immaculate on your taxes and financial terms, what you can do is that head towards Soak, the way our bowlers have been bowling, and accounting and keeping every piece of information here. Yashi Sports sponsoring the best cricketing accessories and equipment to the players so that they can ace in the field of the in this field. Minimo is burgers and fries. If you want to have a quick bite after the overs have completed, you can head there. Entice Construction, Kuldeep Gill of Century 21, Paramount Brokerage, the 6 creation experts in online branding and sports. If you're wondering how they're trying to promote this online, if you see that wonderful reels, and if you're trying to promote something digitally, nowhere better to go than 6 creation. The best architect and profound digital marketers themselves. This has been here. Yuvraj taking the catch. Bhagwan has been amazing. Saad has opened the gates by bowling out Ramiz. And Simarjit has got 1 wicket on his name. Harsh Thakur, 2. And Saad bin Zafar has got 2. The batting lineup looks like Kalpit, Saad, Mansoor, Arman to come in. 3 overs remaining. What can we have? We've got 2 overs pending from Kamalveer Singh, 2 from Simarjeet Tillo, and captain himself has got 1. Gagandeep has got 2 himself. Bhagwan Singh's been brought into attack. Something unusual. Would have thought someone who has his arm rotated, who's warmed up, would have been into attack. But again, Bhagwan Singh, let's see if the strategy brings something. Oh, this is a big. This is a big. Close your eyes and say, where has it gone? Nowhere. I've been a little ambitious and asking too much. I thought this has been hit for a 6. Hasn't connected the part of the sweet spot of the bat, but the fielder station, lucky him, being a lucky survivor of this hunt. Tries to slash, too quick. The ask is too much for the bowling team, but any score here isn't to be taken lightly. My apologies, is because if we take anything in a lighter term, let's remember the game, IPL game between Kolkata. Appeal of out, and the dreaded finger comes up. The dreaded finger. No batsman wants to have a look at the umpire. Says, "You found guilty, mister. Keep walking to the pavilion." There you see the replay. Taking his slow steps, approaching just like a predator. Keeps his line. The ball jags in. There we go. Right dead front, plumb in front of the stumps. The umpire says, "See you later." 6 down. These are going to be the last nails in the coffin. Whatever is done here is going to be counted. Couple of big sixes. Everything's going to be washed off. Washed off. Anyone who's going to be that messiah for UZ Markhor's piling up some good total here. And like we've been talking about, the funny facts of cricket. Cricket being one of the inconsistent and funny games is because we thought that 130, when KKR, Kolkata Knight Riders, was playing against Royal Challengers Bangalore, we thought that we are witnessing one of the low-scoring totals. And what happened after that is very unusual and fascinating, is because Royal Challengers Bangalore was bowled out on 38 or 39, if I remember. Drills it straight to the fielder. Station at short covers. So far, predominantly Patiala Shahi cricket dominating this game. Can they restrict 8 runs and have that mark, a remarkable achievement? Takes on, cries of catches, night sky coming in, the fielder circling underneath, and is it gone? Yes, the batsman is gone, not the ball over the rope. They tried to take the aerial routes. Maybe this could have been the lesson. If someone's trying to take the aerial route and perishing, they could have played alongside the carpet, trying to use the gaps. This ground indeed is a big ground. And it is not about the batsman. If you have a bigger area, you can try to target the shorter boundaries. But this ground, if you look at the dimensions, the surface, the area, it's very circular. And that becomes very difficult for the bowler, a batsman, to target one boundary where they can get the runs. So there hasn't been the taps of run open for the batting team, UZ Markhor. Bhagwan Singh has got 2 wickets, and indeed the addition, what we've been talking about, the new role for Bhagwan Singh to play, what he's got, he hasn't been warmed up, and the commentator has been proved wrong. Very happy when being proven wrong for a spectacular cricketer like Bhagwan Singh. Running in, trying to deliver masterpiece. The single, with the single, the over ends, and the score is 93. 12 more balls coming. Can we see something extraordinary, something heroic? This city, the Brampton region, is known for something extraordinary. Are we witnessing, or is it going to be the anticlimax for Patiala Shahi Cricket Association here. The cricket team has been doing well. We've got a little cute guest here walking past behind Romy Dhaliwal. If your attention is caught to that sweet little guest of us walking past the boundary, and then surely you're enjoying cricket. Gagandeep, the fasty, the speedy bullet, is back into attack. Credits to Jimmy Sharma for arranging this type of level of cricket here. This club has definitely been through the crushes and grinds, and what do you see here? Oh, well, he's hit that like a tracer bullet, but fielder in position. You would be shocked. You would be shocked to know the fact that before 2017, Patiala Shahi Cricket only played tennis ball leagues, tennis ball cricket. And what do you see? The transformation, the transfiguration of these cricketers has been... Oh, what a catch! Would have been, what a catch and what an effort. And who is it? A very own gun fielder. Can you imagine the type of effort he has put in? You got to feel, you got to feel he's given 200 out of 100%. What a effort this is. These are the type of efforts are gold dust to your team. These type of efforts write down your name and you stand by an example to your team for the type of efforts you put in fielding. Nobody talks about batting. Everyone talks about batting. I'm sorry. Everyone talks about bowling. But one thing that goes off the books is how many runs, how many valuable runs are you saving? Just imagine this catch being taken. What a catch this would have been. Absolutely ripper. He sprung like a frog. He's got in the run out, but I think it's very harsh on the fielders when the norms are evolving. I think the fielders should have the quota to get the wickets, because the type of effort what they put in, it's really harsh, really harsh. And I think it's biased for the bowler to take the wicket away. And what a effort that is. Amazing and extraordinary. 97 on board, 8 down. Is there going to be the pack of show? Pushes it. Keeper is the call. Cries. Goes hard. And he's home. 99. Can they achieve 100, or is there going to be a maiden? And I think it's... I'm writing a fairy tale here. Just don't get carried away by my emotions. I'm just writing a fairy tale here. What you can see is that a piece of cricket, piece by piece, taken ahead. Ah, he's cleaned it. What a sight for a fast bowler. Nothing better. Bullseye banging in, rattling the middle stump here. What a delivery. Immaculate, precise, accuracy, pace at its very best. Bullseye, there you go on the replay. Has got a little celebration, nothing. Staring and glaring at the batsman, showing him the way of the dugout. Yes, mister. Keep walking. 99 for 9. Maybe the fairy tales do come true like Cinderella. I'm not sure. One more ball. Are we going to see a pack of the show for UZ Markhor? One ball. Something magical. Something extraordinary. Something superficial. Gagandeep, the speedster. The express. Mansoor, the last man standing, everyone circling, the pride of Lions, Patiala Shahi, again top on the game. They've got their emblem very right, the pride of Lions. The emblem says horse, they are fast, and the lion representing the royalty back to their roots, their heritage, where they've originated from the king of Patiala, who had the fondness, love for the game. Last over, last six balls. We've seen everything here. Clean ball, fast spin, a six being hit. Can we see something here of these last six balls? Whack that. Sweet sound of the bat, but gets the fielder. This has been the fashion. If a batsman is there, if it is a tail ender, this has been fashion from the batsman that they deny the run. So the question is that run going to be heavily imposed on them for not taken? Takes on, and the right decision. Is it right? The fielder, the sweeper covers, comes into picture. He is stationed way far. Yuvraj has got quick sprinting. He's got the quick shoes on, just like Hermes, the messenger of gods in Greek mythology. Some mythical lessons that the Nike is derived. If you look at the origination of Nike, the swoosh has come in from Greek mythology, the god of speed. Used to deliver the messages in Greek mythology with ease and grace. There you go. A cute guest. How can you not love them, fall in love? But here's something. 360 comes nothing. 101 is on board. They've crossed the mark of 100. Three more balls remaining. Bhagwan Singh has let only four runs off his second over. This is second what he's fueling in. Too wide, extra. This is what they wouldn't want to do it. They haven't leaked any runs. Three more balls coming up. Three sixes, three fours, two runs being taken. Oh, nothing. 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 Not even a single. Dot ball. With every dot ball, what they are writing in the cricketing book, it'll be easy for them. At least they should be trying to notch a single and run between the wickets to have a competitive total. This has been one-side dominance here. We thought that it's a two-sided bend game, but nothing again. Trying to head hard, changing his pace. If you look at the length, what he's bowled, he's bowled the previous one slightly ahead of him. Now this one right into the block hole. Fifth stump of the off. Now you're seeing that the grounds being crowded. Everyone coming to witness this magnificent game. Last ball coming in. What is it going to be? Anything that we have not expected of. And second or just a one. The runner wants the second. But to end up, it's just one. And 20 overs completed. 103. A task coming up for the bowlers. A big ask for the bowlers of UZ Markhor to be defended. And 103 on board. Remarkable effort from the bowling side. They have definitely fed on the words of Dilroop as the captain, what they've done. A remarkable feat. And look at the fall of wickets. Three initial blood being dropped initial blood of the UZ Markhors. First blood is on 3 runs, then 2nd, 3rd came in on the same score, 67-67. Then the 4th one on 74-76. So if you look at this fall of wickets, what one prominent fact you would find that there hasn't been a partnership except for the one between wicket number 1 and 2. So that has been the major and concerning problem for UZ Markhors. Live action coming to you. Let's see what goes wrong and right for either of these teams here for the second half. Live action coming up. Let's take a break.
Bye. Gifts like that? Bitch? Then you just seem like you think, yeah, come on, dude, you're gonna be out, bro. Dude, shut up.
Let me pick it.
Mommy, mommy, can I take it this? You can take him in there. Yeah? Yo, they get hella calm. Bro, the other day fucking yo man, that was crazy, bro. I was just walking and I had my AirPods in, right? Bro, the geese come and they're trying to reach this guy, yo, right by Russell D. Barber at the front. I'm just walking by there, bro. Geese come and trying to pick him up. Yo, this guy ran off and it happened to me. This guy ran off, bro. And the leash, I left it for the leash, bro. And then he starts running towards the woods. I run after him. I'm like, okay, what? But this time it was geese. Those geese are vicious, bro. Yeah, they're big, bro. I'm not scared myself. I'm like, go back. Bro, we have to take care of the bank.
Welcome back. They have started already. The proceedings have been proceeded. They've got the established pair of opening, Jannatpreet Singh and Yuvraj Samra, the flamboyant southpaw. Saad is bowling the attack. Not a high ask here, high ask of total. The speedster has to do something extraordinary. Yes, something like that. Pile the dot balls and try to build the pressure, and the end result, taking the wicket away. Saad Khan. They would definitely want to reconcile on the errors, what they have made via their bowling. They want to bowl something what the Patiala Shahi cricket wouldn't have expected them to come off. Something out of the blue. That they've opted a strategy. And one thing, they want to keep it chirpy on the field. But Jannatpreet being Jannatpreet. And utilizing the power play. The ball does not trickle into the boundary. But it gets fine two runs. What a shot that was. Dancing down reminds me of Brendan McCallum dancing down to Mitchell Starc in 2015 World Cup. He's been one of the explosive dynamite openers, or you can say him that he's been that powerhouse like mitochondria in the cells of Patiala Shahi cricket, because the way he has played his innings, the way he has monitored, moderated, he's been the whole and sole responsible person. Again, dances down. This time tries to pull it on the charge. The intent is clear. This is what was lacking from UZ Markhor batsman, that he's trying to come down the track and reading the ball, reading the surface, that he's trying to hook, pull, and playing it on the charge towards covers, extra covers. One over completed. A decent start. That is four runs of the over. Right and left combination. Hasan Adil, the man who was looking in a good touch but had to depart. Has now been bought into the attack. I think this is a masterpiece principle that they've played of right-hand and left-hand combination, because it's not going to be easy for the bowler to pick up the line and the length, because they are batting on with the right-hander and the left-hander. It would give some time as well, a little break for until the field adjustments happen. Takes all this time, goes big. How big is it? Has he cleared the fence? Yes, he has. Take a delight of the shot. No ground in the city can contain Jannatpreet Singh. The name is Jannat, but he can definitely make you see hell if you're bowling on the right wrong track. This man can be an X factor. The exogenous factor what he can bring is that with his power hitting, immense power hitting, the way he hits it, the type of clean hits that has got into his array is amazing. Takes on big, go for another one, but have they got a fielder this time? Don't bother, save your legs for a shot like that. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. We'll have to wait for the signal for the umpire. An amazing effort, absolute remarkable sportsmanship from the fielder. Clear from Jannatpreet. He's not going to wait. He's not going to wait for you to put a bait on. He is a whole different fish in the ocean. If you are going to invite him, he's going to take the invitation up with both his arms open. Widespread, and what a magnificent strike that was. Clean, crisp as you like, over the head of long on. Takes on this time, goes big, heaves it across the square leg. No position. He is making the fielders run hard, asking them to save each and every run. They'll have to muster courage. They'll have to gather all their might, because this ain't going to be easy on a low-scoring game like this. Unless they have quick fall of wickets, which I feel if Jannat and Yuvraj is on the groove, it will be very, very difficult. And we'll have to see the cricket book shots, what Yuvraj plays as well. He's very versatile. This time he slashes, stand talls and slashes. This man is playing on a whole different surface, whole different track. He's come up from a different planet. You might want to call up NASA and say that an alien has landed in this ground. How well he's standing tall, letting the ball come through him. We've seen him play the ball a little late on this delivery and charging up on the foot. We've seen a slog, and what have we not seen? He's hit it in the wee and few more coming up, which Yuvraj shall fulfill through the covers as well, through his high elbow, high profile shots. Takes on this time, couldn't get it. Change of deliveries, change of line and length is something what the bowler would have to look on. And indeed, the type of hammering what he's giving, the shellacking, will make the bowler scratch his head. Takes on, cries of catches. This should be an easy one. Oh, well, this would have been a wicket they were looking for. Was there no judgment of the ball? And if you look, the ball had taken Jannat by surprise. He had no clue what happened, and he was baffled by the delivery. Hard hands. There you see, there was no judgment. He could have moved a few inches back, and had the catch been taken, would have been an early wicket. The ask would have been fulfilled for the UZ Markhor. Two overs completed, and Patiala Shahi are off to a flyer. Credits goes to Jannat Preet Singh, who was on the non-striker's end. The boy, the flamboyant southpaw, will have to take the non-striker end because they've taken a single that keeps Jannat on strike. He is bringing the form. He's carrying the form. He hasn't let that 100 overtake his form and sit up on his head. So that usually we see that 100, and we see that the confidence remains high, but the batsman remains overconfident. This is not from the middle of the bat, from the top side, the sticker of the bat. Couldn't get hold of that. Ends up a single. He's got his acquaintance on the ground, Yuvraj. His family is watching him. Would have wanted to do something wonderful like he usually does for his team. And I don't think so. There's any calculated risk required from Yuvraj unless he wants to display his potential and his wide array of shots, what he's got in his cricketing book. Because one end, Jannat has been slogging like a sledgehammer, and the other end, it would be very easy and convenient for him to find his track, time, take his time and get into his groove. Again, credits to Dilroop for the captaincy that he's taken. Punched off the back foot into the gap and easy running. This is the type of game plan that they are building. The type of game plan is that from one end, Yuvraj is keeping the scoreboard ticking, and from the other end, they're getting big hits. So I think this is a well-balanced strategy of power hitting and a tactful situation on the ground what they are witnessing. Not sufficient runs in the bank. Takes on. Could not get hold of it rightly. He's trying to take on everything like a big jack. Two overs and definitely a flyer start for Patiala Shahi cricket, the type of start they've expected. Tucks off and gets nothing. No shot here, sensible cricket being played. Sensible cricket being played by Patiala Shahi cricket at the minute, because Jannat has given them a flyer. I hope they don't erupt and fall on UZ Markhor, because the league stage what they're playing in is a tough competitive league stage. And every shot, lovely, lovely. Look at this wonderful boy. Look at this, how easy he makes the shot look. The type of pace what he had, how has he managed to pull that shot so easily with grace? Sweet timer of this ball. He is gifted with the wrist work, with timing. Very few that has got timing, hasn't got the wrist work. And few who the wrist work, they haven't got timing. But this man has been gifted with both. Rizwan Chima padded up on the sideline. We've got a couple of other batters as well. They've definitely got something. Good line, good length. That is the type of attack they would want to lead with. Targeting between the stumps. They've got a lot of firepower and the throttle to accelerate their innings. Having Rizwan Chima on the boundary line, padded up, having a word. Saad bin Zafar, the batsman, profound and prolific. And they've got Harsh Thakur who can bat long. Dilrobe who can hit big. They've got a long firepower coming in. They are charged up. But for now, the score moves on to 26 of three overs. Good news for Patiala Shahi is that they haven't lost any wickets and an amazing start. And bad news for UZ Markhor, if they do not want the game to seep and leap out of their hands and they want to dangle on this game, keeping in their clutches would be early wickets, quick breakthroughs is one way out for them, or else they are going home without a win dry. First game of BDCL for Patiala Shahi cricket. And they've started their TDCL journey with a win, and this would be a statement, a positive note, positive environment in the club to have a win in both the tournament league stages to have a win. The dominant right-handed Dhaliwal is yet to come. The keeper, Romy Dhaliwal, he can take you on for a ride and easy as you grant. And Jannat Preet is showing that I can also defend. It isn't that I'm going to go after the ball. Every ball, like all hell breaks loose. Medium pacer goes down the track, cries of catches. Will it be taken? Oh, very well tried. What a valiant effort. Brave indeed. Not easy when you've got your head hanging. The similar catch what Rizwan Chima had tried as well in the early start of innings. Irrespective of the exposure and the amount of experience you have, you've got your body in motion, you're sticking your head up, running reverse. It's not easy. So the type of fielding effort it is outstanding. Directed in the stumps, he allowed the ball to come towards him. Nothing in hurry, he's not in a rush, playing late, and gets single, keeps the scoreboard ticking. 29 without loss. The team environment here has been so good, so healthy, so positive. I've been looking at the interviews of the international cricketers that recent game. Let's take an example, an instance from the one of the most successful franchisee cricketing clubs, Chennai Super Kings, when most of the cricketers have been abandoned. Look at Ajinkya Rahane. He's got a phenomenal record. If you've seen 2013 and 12, the way he played for Rajasthan Royals, goals. He was on the move, on the charge, always attacking, aggressive. But if you look at recent years, that has come like a grey area to him, that he's been dropped out, and now he's been picked up by that side. That yellow jersey has got something special, and that special element, the sprinkle in that yellow jersey, what you have is that healthy environment. And similarly, if I look at the players and if I look at the devised strategy, the way they formulate, the way they head this club, the way they are operating, I feel the same way what I hear from the players is because they feel that they are themselves in this club. They are not pressurized for runs. They feel like family, and the team environment is so healthy, so good that, you know, there's no pressure because there's someone who's almost every time chipping in for you. You've got experience from the expert, the World Cup 2011 vice captain Rizwan Cheema, who can forget his monstrous hitting ability and his strategical game plans. He himself, who's got up roll under his sleeve. Oh, lovely. He's crunched that. So talking about that healthy environment, what this team creates, what this club creates, is impeccable for any player. For any player who's playing up with their strengths, is important that how they find their groove, how they are backing it up. They feel that it's very comfortable. And if a player is playing in a comfort level, up to their comfort level, we'll get back to that, about the comfort level and the type of environment what they're having here. Four overs completed. And the score is 29 without any loss. Heading, so far, so strong. And the responses from the player is because when they get into the groove and the comfort level they are in, it becomes very easy for them to pick runs and becomes very easy for the team to believe in. So the type of backing up is the key strength, the key picking, the youngsters, most of the slot has been. And one of the important factors where we don't get carried away by this is the worm what we are looking at. If you look at the worm in one or two overs, has taken a leap, a sudden significant jump. Whereas if you look at the steady worm, blue, which is for UZ Markhor, is that they have gradually increased. There was a slight increase in the run rate where you see that fifth and sixth over, then again it started to decline. It started to deplete with the fall of wickets. But here, if you see, there are no fall of wickets here, and going strong with the grip on the game from the initial phrase itself, Patiala Shahi are saying that they have pocketed this game. Quick running between the wickets. Oh, well-directed throw. They are coming. He's slipped. Little banter on the field. Relaxed body posture. Looking at Yuvraj, this man is cool as a cucumber. The reason why this guy is so highly praised is because the type of cricketing shots he takes out, the age he has, he's so tenacious with the cricket shots and he's so resilient with his performance. Over and over, if you're expecting a player to live up to the expectation and perform, I think this is something what Yuvraj is expected of, and he's been consistently delivering to this club. The club has shown faith in him, and a type of club where they are nurturing this young budding cricketer who's full of potential and zeal, and he's repaying them back. He's taken on. Is that a commentator's curse falling upon him? I don't think so. The swirling ball has helped him survive another day for Yuvraj to go home. ...32 runs on the board so far. Lovely crunch of the bat. This is like some delicious recipe a chef makes. Similarly to a cricketer, if you find that good spot connect and that crunch of the bat, you're really having a delightful dessert. Well, this club has been like a family here for all the players. The type of the promotions and the strong backing up what Patiala Shahi has done to the cricketing players. So talking about the family, congratulations to Navi Dhaliwal for a baby boy. How can we forget the newest addition to this lovely, he's heaved back, he's rocked back, quickly got into the position, and is played on spot. Talking about family, how can we forget the new addition who's healthy and gracious, having a baby boy. Congrats to Navi Dhaliwal. Talking about being congratulated, I think the feat, the one of the accolades Yuvraj Samra holds is that being one of the best in this BDCL tournament himself. Best batsman in 2022. He's been studded with that award in 2022 for being one of the best in BDCL. Thirty-six on the mark. Some abruption. If you look at the statistics, a lot of number and data-oriented team where they also are EQ, where they have the kinships, empathy attached. They are also data-oriented. If you look at that, too fast, too quick. He is in absolute disarray. Wanted to capitalize on that. That is talking about the statistics of the team, that they've been last year group's champion. They've got that under their belt. But what they wanted to do is that they've been knocked out of the semi-final in the final over of when facing against Dolphins, Mississauga Dolphins, if I'm not wrong. So I think they've been knocked off the tournament, and that wound is still fresh, and they want to redeem themselves. Oh, lovely, lovely. This guy bats on for some more time on the crease. The fielders are going to be just spectators, and everyone's going to be delightful about the lovely shots he's going to make and he's going to play. End of the over. Five overs completed. The score is 40 without any loss of wickets. Signs of emergency to have a comeback. I think if the game is halfway through, five overs completed. Current run rate, they're proceeding on 8 per over. And couple of more runs, they are going to be comfortably home. Are we going to see some spin in action? Brief pause to get the field set up. No, again, they've opted for the medium pacer. Cuts off to the fielder, who's stationed at backward point. Takes on, gets onto his pads. Dances off the ground. How big is that? Can you get 12 runs off the shot? It is out of the park. Not out of the boundary, but out of the box. This is humongous. He is being ruthless. The way he has danced off the track and the way he has got his fast hands, this is a big one. Last time when I saw someone hit that big towards floodlights, there was Rayan Pathan with his immense power in his arms, and this time he dances off the track and he's taken off in a flash. How quickly has he used his feet? He's used his hands. What an amazing strike. Sensible cricket. Yes, no, direct hit. and Yui would have been gone. He would have been running, but a good call. He showed confidence in his fellow non-striker. And the faith has been repaid with the run completed. Takes on, this time Yuvraj showing his colours to the cow corner. Just gets one, wonderful throw. That's a lovely throw.
This is what this team is made of. They conflate.
They bring in the energy from transferring from one player to another player, irrespective of them being certain dugout. They conflate their energy, they bring in, they fuse in one single entity. The key strength, 6 overs completed. We'll have that word about this team spirit and team environment again. 6 overs completed and the score is 49 on the loss of 0 wickets. The Manhattan over by over, if you look at that big buildings, that is definitely by the Patiala Shahi in orange. And the buildings, if you compare that, there have been a couple of overs that they are moving slightly slow, but comparatively they have managed to pull off runs in one over by targeting a specific bowler. And talking about the team environment, they have conflated. You do not battle, or you are not against a player, certainly. The type of conflation they have, they're bringing in their energy, they're fusing in their energies together. It's like you are up against the whole team, not a specific player who's on the crease. So, cheers outside the ground, who are sitting in the dugout, that definitely bolsters, encourages the batsman to stick and to complete his task, the assigned task. Jannat batting of 32 in 21 balls. Yuvraj of 17 in 15 balls. Moves back, rocks back. Fielder station. Is it going to be the first breakthrough? Yes, it is. Nevertheless, it hasn't come too late. The first blood drawn in form of Jannat Preet Singh, who was well set and trying to creep back into game. And who is it? Once gone. The power hitter, the man himself, the myth, the man, Rizwan Cheema, walks in to show his talent and display his master strokes. One of his key strokes and master stroke has been that he picks up the ball so well. And what a fine knock. Jannat Preet has done the damage and he is coming back. He's not happy, definitely, because he is a passionate cricketer. And he's unhappy because he hasn't completed the task for his team. But again, what a powerful fine knock by Jannat Preet. He's delivered the damage and yet again stood up for his team. New man walks in. Who is it? The man you know. The man you are well aware of. When Canada represented in 2011, we focus and emphasize on the fact this, on this fact over and over,
because in a country where the sports is promoted, where winter lasts for 8 months and practicing indoor, it isn't easy. And this man has represented his country and playing for this club. Again, easy pickings. If you're going to bowl him there, he's going to bat whole day without any trouble. And the type of fitness regime this man has, like I've told you, he is having his age just going backwards. He's having some, definitely a potion that is not allowing him to grow old, but he's growing younger and younger, fitter and fitter. He's off the mark in fashion. Takes on, wanted to go big. Says no. Would be a great impression for Yuvraj to pick up his mind. The type of experience, the type of immense knowledge, Rizwan, and especially the current captain of Canadian team, Saad bin Zafar, carries. For him to read, there's his muzzle power. Easy pickings. The reason why I've been emphasizing about he representing, we were talking about 8 months being winter, and it is very difficult for someone to practice, and he representing his country when the greats of cricketing world, Sachin, Ramesh, Tendulkar, the god himself, and the budding Virat Kohli, the king himself, were established in this 2011 World Cup. So I think he's been the legend for Canadian cricket, Rizwan Chima himself. And opposite, he is the uprising player with him, who is going to make a mark in Canadian cricket soon, if things go well and if planned so, by God willingly. Under Chima's leadership skill, under his brain, I think there's a lot of cricket that Yuvraj can explore, different ways, different methods, different practices, different techniques, what they both are going to share on. And one thing has been in common between Yuvraj and Chima is that they have that passion for cricket. And despite being a big personality, Chima, he hasn't insinuated that fear, or he hasn't shown that non-approachable personality to any of them. It is so easy, so good, the environment he creates around the youngsters who are so approachable to approach him and to have a word with him. So it's going to be a very good platform to leverage for Yuvraj. End of the over, one wicket down, 54 more runs, exactly 50 needed from 13 overs. Nikhil Datta. Hiding his ball, and Chima leaves it. How easy. If you look at his leaving standard, he watches the ball till the very end so that it does not turn sharply into his stumps. Takes on and beats him. This is the type of length and the line, irrespective of how big of the caliber you have, you got to respect that line and delivery. Nothing is superior over cricket to any player or anyone. Bangs and shot. This time, typical like Qais Ahmed from Big Bash League, what we've seen, that he surprised Andre Russell in 2016 or 15, that he took him by a surprise where he had to bring on his helmet. Pulls it. Shot delivery. Varun Chakravarti is one of the names in the Indian Cricketing Premier League that has picked up wickets with shot
length deliveries because he has the level of pace and it does not give time to get into the position and whack him around the park. Like Patiala Shahi cricket, they'll have to conflate their confidence, bring into one entity and fuse in together. It's already 10 and we are heading towards the closure of the game. Easy single being pegged. Three required, nothing but purely formalities remaining, except if they get any wickets or hat tricks here, that puts some pressure on Patiala Shahi cricket, which is difficult, not impossible. Over completed, 48 required of 12 overs, 72 balls remaining. And they've got 48 runs to score on the scoreboard. 56 on the board right now. Another over to be started. It's the spin twin along with Nikhil Datta. Oh, well flighted. But Yuvraj is converted into a full toss, going down and hitting straight to the long on. And it's not going to be easy for the fielders because the type of time they are getting for the field set, having the left and right combination. So Yuvraj would be like a thorn to them that they would want to get rid of. Bank shot. And he's got power. We'll have to see the ball teasing. They've got some grass, which has saved a couple of more runs here. And not let the ball creep in to the fence. It's 2 runs to add on to total. Can this be the night that he shows his batting skills, the colors, what he is have hidden under his sleeve? This one was a quicker one. Yes, no, yes, no. Rizwan was late to respond. Looks at that. Sounds beautiful. Has he found the fielder? False shot. And this is amazing. This is like tearing both the fielders in between and he's found the fence. A boundary that we've seen after a long spell that they haven't been hit for. A single. Left-hander, back on strike, has been pretty decent. We've seen some good cricketing shots. Straight, and this is what we've been talking about. Easy pickings for Yuvraj on the leg side. It's just a gift. He didn't try to hit the ball too hard, just caressed it away for 4. They've got two boundaries in this over and they are in a hurry to finish the game. I'm not sure if they want to wait along till 20 overs and they would want to complete it as early as possible. They've brought Nikhil Datta to operate from the other end. And takes on, appeals. Yes, 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 yes. Dreaded finger. He's got the man. Rizwan Cheema. Right struck in front of his pads. And he says he's been evicted out. There you see the replay. Tries to play a slog sweep across the line. Hitting the umpire nods. The appeal is full of conviction. Was enough to convince umpire. One more down. I think they would want to save wickets and finish it off as early as possible. This is the last time that I've seen them bat together. They snatched the victory away on the same ground. And that was a last league stage match when the Patiala Shahi cricket was crowned as the league stage champions. This was the partnership. And they've got the dominating Romit Dhaliwal. He's a left-hander himself. The left and left combination. Oh, that is a ripper. The batsman has got no answers to that. Except for allowing it to pass safely to the keeper's pouch. Leaves it again. Seeing the ball. Yes, it's the call. Dear friends, they've got a good chemistry combination and communication amidst them. They've played a lot of games together. So communication isn't the problem for them. They know the type of cricket they play. Tries to bowl his arm, one slip in position, going aggressive. And quick running between the wickets. This has been the key here. Despite the wickets have fallen, they haven't let that pressure build up because of good running between the wickets. This has been essential. The scoreboard isn't stagnant if you actually see that. So this has been a key figure. The Australian strategy again to keep the scoreboard moving. Nikhil Datta has bowled two overs so far, three conceded and just one wicket. Ramanveer Dhaliwal and Yuvraj Samra. Yuvraj has said, so it will be expected. Lovely, he goes down the track. Fielder, nicely fielded. Takes on. This is lovely. He creams it away. Can you believe that? Sweetly timed and crisply played. Shot of the night for me. That has gone down on one knee and played it with so ease and grace. And trust me, it's not so easy the way this man makes the batting look easy. They've collected a boundary. Too far for me to witness. This time goes big. Is that in the gap or the fielder's station? Somewhere. They are slightly hesitant to take twos. This is one thing that what I've witnessed for the running between the wickets for them. There isn't an actual problem to run between the wickets when these two are batting, but actually converting ones into twos is something what they would want to focus on. Rocks back, waits for the ball, and this time says no, straight to the fielder, who's at extra cover region. The required run rate is 3. Easy pickings. Culpeth has conceded 24 and he's bowling his third over. Picked up one. This is absolutely obnoxious out of the blue. And irrespective of what it was, the catch. This is a bumper. Unexpected from the spinner. The umpire signaled as a no ball. Quite dangerous. Free hit. And Yuvraj has got the license to expose his wicket in play for this one delivery. Can he capitalize? This one's again slipped away. Would the no ball continue? We'll have to look. Yes, the leg umpire signal for the no ball again. Continuity of no balls. And the turmoil continues. They are in disbelief of what has happened. The free hit continues. This conversation between the umpires, and one more free hit. This time brings on Ramanveer Taliwal. Will he be able to capitalize? The left-hander in some fashion. Takes on, sits on. And could not get much out of it. They've got 5 runs off the no ball and 2 and then 1 in that free hit. A long over. 33 is what Culpeth has conceded till now. This time goes down straight as an arrow. Has he found the gap? Fielding, exceptional fielding effort here. Eleven overs completed and the score is 87 on the fall of 2 wickets. Ramanveer being the captain of 50 overs, long format game. Young shoulders have been given the opportunity again and again in this club. How consistent has this club been to youngsters? A prolific club to represent. And we shall be talking about that again once, but looking over by over chart, the Manhattans, you see, this has been one of the most expensive overs of this game. how prolific and how exceptional this club has been to put the responsibility on the shoulders of young Ramanveer Taliwal, who's been standing, showing his batting skills time and time. And this is how you get paid off by your club, getting an opportunity to captain your side for the long format of the game. 17 required. Obstruction. We'll have to start over again. Datta with the ball in hand. Gets off the track. Raman's taken first one quickly. Will they be coming back for the second one? Easy again. Just 15 required. Is there going to be a punch off the back foot? Nicely bowled on the tight line. Oh well, we've got a packed house. We've got a packed house full of audience who are enjoying to the very moment. 15 runs, his cut off the back foot. Two again. Raman's taken the first one hard, but have to pause there. The fielding effort, an amazing effort. One thing that have been that has been wrong in the batting to UZ Markhor, I would reckon that would be the intent, the attitude, the positive attitude, what they've lacked in the shot making. That is because in the early succession, in the early regular interval, having the wickets falling, they could have tried to show the intent by exhibiting that. That was bowled with immense pace, but that did not affect even an inch to Yuvraj. So I think that would have been something what the UZ Markhor would have wanted to change a little, improvise on, and get back stronger. And on the bowling part would have been something they would want to restrict the singles, because the singles have let the boundaries come out of easy and the runs have been in flux. He's allowed the ball to come closer to him, closer to his body. Well required. The run rates under two. Just easy pickings at the minute. I don't think so they would want to lose any wicket from here. Required. New man brought into the attack. Takes nothing of the very first ball of Mansoor. Would they be closing at the game in this over is the question. Or there's another two overs or an over to come to spare, and there's a due factor. He's unhappy with that. The umpire has got a grin on the face. He's bowling diagonally. of the back foot. Ten required. Just two, one big hit and a boundary away. Can Raman do it? Takes it off. Easy single. I don't see anyone padded up in the team, and it is what they do not want to lose the wicket. Gets down. His mark just gets one. This club has been facing and showing their boldness every time that they've been put onto bat and have been restricting teams to the best of their capacity to their low totals. Would have been in trouble if the ball would have stuck to his pads first than his bat. Cuts off. That's a crisp shot. That's a crisp shot. And the ball teasing the fielder. Will it reach the boundary? No, it doesn't. It's very difficult for the shot makings here. And when you hit it along the carpet, isn't easy to find a boundary. Just six. Run a ball. 6-2. Do the formalities and complete.
Or against the wind, chakka hua. Flat. Flat.
Six deliveries can Datta take game slightly deeper, or this is the over for the closure. They are making them go hard for every run. There hasn't been an easy picking for them. The fighting spirit is still on for UZ Markhor. They haven't let anything easy for free. Bangs and shot, does not connect. His eyes were vivid as soon as he saw the half tracker. Takes on this time. Coming back for a second one. Yes, no, and no. Five required. This five remaining leaves it. And the umpire says, within the line, tram line. Full toss, hits it in the gap, coming back for the second, says no. The game's going to go slightly deeper than what we've expected for the closure. And 100 comes up for Patiala Shahi Cricket. Takes on, but gets nothing. Wanted to finish the game in style. Four remaining. We've got one more over to go. Opening goes on in style, and has he taken, found the fielder? Would have been risky. Yes, no. Come back for the second. And they've got two more to edge the name of Patiala Shahi Cricket in the book of victory. It's two remaining. Would Mansoor make them strive hard for these two runs? Easy one. The scores are level, and you have a comfortable winner that's home. There's one ball pending. And everyone standing on the boundary line to celebrate. They've got one run pending, and they'll have to wait to celebrate. A loser, and UV says yes, and that's the closure. They finish the game off again. Yuvraj has stood tall. They've seen some power smacking from Jannatpreet, who had made them come home with a comfortable win after his powerful smacking. And then we've seen a glimpse of hits from Rizwan Cheema, then Ramanveer Dhaliwal taking on the charge. That's the closure. That's all. And again, it turns out to be Patiala Shahi, your favorite cricket club, winning. What we see the next game. So TND is they've registered their first win, and of the first game in BDCL, they've registered their first win in this tournament again. A positive note to start on for the tournaments and this year summer for this cricketing club. So we shall join you again in the next game. Thank you.
I'm like, film them? Huh? Want me to go film them?
What?
Want me to go film them? Should I film? Like, do they want to do interviews? You turned the stream off, right?
Can you put this in the...
Get a battery pack. It's better.